Hi there, how are you doing? Today, I want to talk with you about role-based access control in ASP.NET Core application. Specifically, I want to show you how to implement it using JWT token. RBAC is simple and powerful. It supports all kinds of combinations, like one user could be assigned with one role or multiple roles. A resource could be protected to allow only one role to access, or it could allow multiple roles. ASP.NET Core WebAPI have great support for RBAC scenarios and made it very easy to implement. Let's take a look. I assume that you are familiar with the basics of JWT authentication authorization flow already. If that is not the case, please check out my other video talking about those basics. I'll put a link on the right upper corner. The code base that I'm going to work on in this video is also based on the code from that video. What we are seeing here is a protected resource controller again. On line 10, we said it requires authorization by apply the authorize attribute. As long as the user provide a valid token, that means they have been signed in and will return the resource. What I'm going to do is I'm going to put in a requirement for role validation. So not only the user need to provide a valid token, they also need to provide the proper role information. Otherwise, the request would just be rejected. That's how we protect the resources in RBAC. And then we'll work the backwards to add the role information into the access token that we issued. Then we verify that it works that way. Let's go. To require a role of a user, it is as simple as adding the role's value to the authorized attribute. For example, here we require the user have a user role. Let's run it. Since we haven't updated the token that we are issuing, there's no role information in it. And if we try to invoke the get protected resource directly with this token, the request will be rejected. Now let's add the role information while we issuing the token. Notice that the user's credential has been verified at this moment already. I'm going to hard code the role information here, but in real life, we might need to query the role information from other places like a database or something else. Now let's go back to the Postman to see how it works. This new token should have role information on the payload. Now it works. Let's actually check out what is on the token now. As you can see, now we have the role information on the payload. You might notice that I didn't update the token validation parameter to accept the role information. It is already there. That's because there is a convention. Let's see how can you pick up a custom role name on the token. This will be very useful when the token issuing is not controlled by our own code. To demonstrate that, I'll update the claim type name for role to role ABC. I'll show you in the Postman, a token like this will be rejected. What we need to do in this case is to update the token validation parameter. Here we are telling the server, hey, when you get an access token from the client, fetch the row information from the payload named row-abc. Let's verify this actually works. Before I use the token, I want to show you it is still row-abc on the payload. Okay, let's use that to fetch the protected resource. So far, we've seen how to update the attribute on the resource to protect it with row information. We've seen how to update the token issuer so that the row information could be put on the payloads. We have also seen how to update the token validation parameter so that the server knows where to fetch the row information on receiving an access token. Now let's look at some more complex scenarios. Let's start with allowing the resource to be accessed by multiple rows. It is actually very simple. We just use a comma separate list. For example, I'm allowing either user or admin to access this resource. To verify it, let me update the user's role to admin. Remember, this is the newly allowed role on the resource. Let's see if the new token works. If it does, it means not only the user but also the admin can access the protected resource at this moment. Okay, that's one resource, multiple rows. Now let's look at another case where a user have multiple rows. Let me revert the change so that the resource can only be accessed by the role of user. Coming back to the token issuer, currently the token is not going to work because the user is in role of admin. Instead of changing the role back to user, let's try add a second role. Pay attention, this claim have a same type name. And that is how we assign multiple roles to a same user. Let's wait for the build and see this in action. It works. Now, if you're wondering how the token looks like, let's decode it. As you can see, the row payload becomes an array. And that is how we assign multiple roles to the user. Thanks for watching. I hope you enjoyed this video. Feel free to comment below. Please don't forget, your like and subscribe would be my best motivation to keep it up. I'll see you in the next video. Until then, take care.